friends. Good morning. Happy Tuesday. It's May 5th. It's Cinco de Mayo, May 5th. I'm going to go through our day. There are some different things in here, so just want to make sure you know what's going on. You're going to go ahead and make sure that at 10 o'clock you check Google Classroom for the Google Meet link for Sam's Star of the Week morning meeting. Sam, if there's anything you want me to know ahead of time before share time, let me know. Otherwise, we'll see some of your items, your favorite book. If you have any pictures to hold up and show us, that would be great. This is an optional. You should be joining us because as a class, we're all coming together. Give me a minute. If it's 10:01 or 9:58 and you don't see the link, just relax. I don't forget. I have alarms on my phone that go off to remind me. Just give me a minute. I'm in the middle of something, but I will have the link there. Okay. Down here, I'm at work from friends, and I'm thinking it's because we forgot to share it or we forgot to upload it for some reason. So for writing, you had a new editing and revising Google slideshow that Mr. Michael and us worked on. And yesterday you were supposed to read some paragraphs and answer the questions on it. It was multiple choice. You're just supposed to put it in. So I need it from Alex, Owen, Connor, Lucas, Sam, Evelyn, Julian, Haley, and Claudia. Finish it up. So if you finished it, great. Share it with me. If you didn't do it, you need to do it today along with today's assignment, please. Math on Seesaw. I'm missing math from Allie, Alexis, Garrett, Evelyn, and Claudia. It was supposed to be uploaded to Seesaw. You're supposed to take the words and write the definitions for mean, median, mode, range, minimum, maximum. So that's something you need to make sure you do today. This writing is for my friends only. So if you go to Mr. Michael, she might be missing your work too. So you should probably think, did I share my reading with her? Did I share my writing with her? Okay. So grammar, patterns of powers, you're looking at using quotation marks when someone speaks. Book of the day. Your spelling, I haven't heard from friends. So I'm thinking we're okay with the meaning of the words, which is great. If not, let me know. Science, you're going to go on to Seesaw, so seesaw.me, and you're going to complete an activity in simple circuits. So making sure that you have your load, your light bulb, whatever you're trying to light up or turn on or make move, and then you have your wires that connect to it, and then it connects usually to a power source, and we've been saying a simple circuit has a battery. And if electrons flow out of the battery, the negative side, they go through the wires, they light up the light bulb, or they turn on the fan, or they buzz the buzzer, whatever is supposed to happen to the load. And then they go out and back in the positive side of the battery. So you're going to be making some of them. I don't believe there's anything to really hand in today. It's just like a game you're going to be playing. Math, here's your definitions from yesterday. Today you're going to do some work with it, but looking at fractions as well with the line plot. So you have your video to watch from Mrs. Harity, and then you have your work of what you're doing. So down here, you have to find the minimum, the maximum, the range, the mode, and the median. The minimum is the smallest number on the number line with an X over it. So right now I see there's a zero. That's not the minimum because there's no X over it. No data is a zero. But I see that there's a 1/8, which is the smallest number here, and there's an X over it. So that's the smallest number for the minimum. You have your maximum, same thing, which is the largest number with an X over it. Your range is taking the largest and the smallest and subtracting it to see what's in between. Mode is a number that shows up the most, which one has the most X's over it. And median is the middle number, the one you find in the middle of all the data. And then this says how much rain fell on 2/1, 2/6, and 2/2 combined. So you have to find 2/1 for the date, 2/6 for the date, and 2/7. So that's February up here, and then add them together. Okay, let me know if you need help. You're going to take your answers that you do on a piece of paper and upload it to Seesaw, please. Reading, you have an article called Gut Allergies, so you're going to make sure you're working on that. Writing is what we talked about. It's that slideshow. If you don't have it, you didn't do it yesterday, go back to Monday's distance learning on Google Classroom. Open it, go to writing, file, make a copy, and then you can work on it from there. So you have slides 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, and 14 today. Read aloud, special, check Seesaw, see if there's anything updated for media or art, and then our brain breaks as always. Please, if you need help, that's why I'm here. So make sure that you're getting your work to me or you're asking me for help if you need it. And I will see you around 10 o'clock for Sam's meeting. Let's see where.